We're giving ourselves birthday wishes today, as this is our 12th programme. Can I also thank everyone who's contributed over the last year to make the St. J's Group monthly supplement what it is. This programme simply wouldn't be the same without you. This month we'll be reminding ourselves about Easter, day three of Matt Orr's time at General Synod, from Rob about our children's ministry, and of course some testimonies from you.
Well, Margaret and I served together for more years than we can remember, but we're very pleased now to be members of PCC at Peasdown. We've been welcomed with open arms and we're delighted to be there, and especially this morning, of course, it's been beautifully and sunny, so best wishes to everybody.
Yes, wish everybody a happy Easter, and nice to be on the new PCC.
Hey everyone, if we've not met before, my name's Matt and I'm one of your lay representatives for General Synod here in Bath and Wells. And General Synod's a bit of a weird and wonderful world. This is my second meeting and we met late last year and I'm still getting to grips with a lot of it. But I thought, rather than sending out a big long newsletter, I'd just bring you guys with me, share a little bit of the highlights, the insights and what goes on, and hopefully try to explain a few things along the way. So if you're up for that, I want you to stick around. And here we are for the final day. Not quite sure what we're going to film today. I'm maybe just going to try to catch up with a few people, hear their thoughts, and hopefully get some familiar faces for you. But we've got one more day to go and then we're heading back on home to Bath and Wells. So we're just leaving church house. The final session's ended. We had a little meeting with the house of laity to finish things off. Now we're going to head and get the train back to Bath, and at some point later this evening we'll give a summary of today. I didn't get too many clips, but yeah, hopefully we'll get it all sorted. And I've made it back to my flat here in Bath. I'm gonna have to be a little bit quiet because my flatmate has already gone to bed. But I had a safe journey back. Even had dinner with my vicar tonight, completely unrelated to General Synod, but very pleasant nevertheless. Finally, thank you for joining me on this journey. As I say, this is much more my thing rather than a written report, newsletter or email. If you have any questions, do get in contact. And if you have any questions you'd like me to propose to Synod, do get in contact. My email is matt.orr@wearemovement.net. I'd love to be able to do that. It's a privilege to get to serve you. It's a privilege to get to serve our diocese and the church on a national level, but most importantly, to serve God and be led by His Holy Spirit.
Just before Jesus was going to the cross, he shares with his disciples a story that helps explain what will happen when Jesus returns. When the Son of Man comes in his glory, together with his angels, he will sit in state on his throne, with all the nations gathered before him, and he will separate people one from the other as a shepherd separates the sheep from the goats, putting the sheep to his right and the goats to his left. Then the king will say to those on his right, "Come, those whom my father has blessed, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat, thirsty, and you gave me a drink, a stranger, and you made me welcome. Naked, you clothed me, sick, you visited me in prison, and you had time for me." Then the righteous will answer, "But Lord, when did we see you hungry and give you food, or thirsty and give you a drink? When did we see you a stranger and make you welcome, or naked and clothed you? When was it that we saw you sick or in prison and visited you?" Then the king will answer, "I tell you the truth. Whenever you did it to the least of your brothers and sisters, you did it also to me." Do you remember your first chemistry experiment at school? Almost certainly, it involved a piece of litmus paper dipped into a test tube of liquid to see if it turned red or blue, indicating acid or alkali. There is something of that test in the words of Jesus concerning the sheep and the goats. Only this time, the test concerns something very different: how faithfully we have responded to Christ. What are the distinguishing features we should look for? Doctrinal soundness, faith that can move mountains, gifts of the Spirit, an impeccable record of church attendance. Not according to this parable, they're not. What counts, rather, is whether we have responded to people in need, whether we have shown our faith in action, expressing through our care and compassion the love of Christ. That, we are told, is the litmus test of Christian discipleship. Of course, we need to consider such words in the light of Christ's teaching concerning mercy and forgiveness. But we should not use that to evade or tone down their challenge. Faith may not depend on works, but it ought to result in them, at least in part. The warning here is not so much that Jesus will reject us, but that through turning our back on others, we may find that we have rejected him.
Hosanna, 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 Hosanna fil a'ali.
Hosanna, 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 Hosanna fil a'ali.
Ooh.
Thank you for being with us. It's always a delight to see you. I trust you enjoyed our latest programme, and can I please continue to encourage you to send material in for our next programme, which will be aired on Sunday the 5th of